I don't have a suffering problem. I have a continuity problem. This is the gist of the entire situation. What I'm doing here is encouraging you to be a good student and ultimately a successful student. I'm not really a teacher, I'm a student. I don't know if I'm a good student or a bad student, but I know I'm a student. And that's what everybody has to be eventually. And they have to see the wisdom of the situation, of what to do, what's the remedy. And that is to fold all problems that we think we have into just one problem that we actually have. All our problems and that we're suffering from, suffering is an attempt to limit suffering, to limit a greater suffering. This identification with bodies and with form is an attempt to limit what we believe is an infinite suffering, infinite deprivation. But this is imaginary. The deprivation where we fear, the infinite deprivation, is imaginary. And where does it come from? It comes from us, spirit, wanting to be greater than God, and thereby trying to distance, separate ourselves from reality. So when we do that, we feel that we're being deprived of everything, since we want to be greater than everything. And then we blame God for the deprivation, say God is trying to deprive us of everything. And that's the overwhelming fear. And so what we have done is we've tried to limit the scope of that fear by identifying with this tiny little form we call the body and the suffering of the body. And we feel we're being very successful at limiting the fear. But the fear is imaginary. God is not trying to deprive us of anything. So all the suffering is entirely unnecessary, the suffering of the body. We don't need to limit suffering because there is no suffering in reality. There is no deprivation. And yet we're so used to identifying with the body and with form and with that we're afraid to give it up. That's called the continuity problem. So God knows this. And God says, you only have one problem. It's the continuity problem. So agree with God and say, yeah, that is the only problem I have. So whatever your suffering is, just say, I don't have a suffering problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a health problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pain problem. I have a continuity problem. Fold all your suffering and miseries, etc., of this little body into the continuity problem so that you're on the same page with God and then the remedy will be understood. If God gives a remedy we don't understand, it will freak us out and say, God's trying to deprive us of something. It's a trick. It's a trick. And we will flee from it. Because if our suffering ends up being taken away from us, we're afraid, oh my gosh, we're going to be overwhelmed by some greater suffering, right? So we see these bodies, identifying with these bodies, as like safety. A safe harbor in a gigantic storm. We think there's some vast, huge storm of deprivation trying to wipe us out, and we have these little bodies, and we think that we found a little safe harbor here where we can limit the suffering. So what I've seen in the world is that people are totally addicted to their suffering, and it's the most important thing there is as far as identifying with this body. And when it gets lessened, they get all jittery, and they have to pull back more suffering into their lives in order to feel quote-unquote safe. So we think that the remedies that we apply don't work. There's only one sovereign remedy, which is to say, to transfer our concern from all this suffering and misery over to the continuity problem. That's where the problem can be solved. That's where our real problem can be solved. Only there, with continuity problem. This is what being a student on the path is all about, actually. And everybody has to do it eventually. I'll tell you this. We live in a pit of vipers, a den of vipers in this world. I just opened the paper and it's just like, oh, it's just overwhelming. Such an incredibly off-track, bad situation in the world right now. Truly, truly a den of vipers. So nobody can afford to not be a student of truth at this time. Otherwise, I don't even want to say. So I'm just setting an example here because I'm certainly tired of suffering and this stupid folly of a body, using a body to limit suffering. using form to limit suffering, having our experience shrunken down to such a narrow, 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 incredibly, infinitesimally narrow perspective. And then, of course, everyone in the world celebrating that perspective, that incredibly narrow perspective, celebrating it like it's salvation. And truly, the world believes it is. The world believes that this incredibly narrow, unbelievably uncomfortable, suffering nightmare is salvation. They think it's saving us from complete spiritual devastation. And so the problem is here is to turn that around. And it's very difficult. But we have no choice but to do so, because the fear, our fear of complete spiritual devastation is completely imaginary. There's none of that whatsoever. God is not trying to deprive us of anything. We are trying to deprive ourselves of reality so that we can have more than reality. That's the origin of our problem. And yet now, it's a continuity issue with us. And God recognizes that we have a continuity issue. God doesn't recognize anything else but except the continuity issue. That is recognized and addressed. That is addressed, and we have been given the medicine for the continuity issue, the remedy for it. But first, we have to practice transferring our agreement over to that, yes, actually, the continuity problem is the only problem I really have. This other stuff is just imaginary devices I've been using to try and limit the suffering that I thought God was trying to rain down upon me. So, I don't have a suffering problem. I have a continuity problem. This is the medicine. Just use this medicine. It's like taking, I used it yesterday. I got through, you know, about 2/3 of the day, and then started stumbling. So, it's like a workout. And you won't necessarily just breeze through it every day, but you have to keep working at it. And the results will be amazing. I woke up this morning, and I suddenly realized there's nothing that I need to do that the body needs to do. There's nothing that actually needs to be done at all. I don't need to do anything with the body. You know, just like this, boom, instant sense of like freedom. We use the body. We try to, again, limit suffering. We welcome suffering in the body. Suffering is inevitable. And we try to put a silver lining, like we tell ourselves all these stories about the body and how important it is and how it's evolving and doing blah, 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 blah. Those are all cover stories for what we're really doing. What we're really doing is we're trying to limit this imaginary suffering deprivation to a little tiny, tiny speck, and then think that we're good. It's a defense. It's a defense. Identification with the body is a defense. That's all that it is. God didn't make bodies. God did not make form, okay? Form and bodies is something that the Son of God, Spirit, has imagined to try and limit deprivation. Try to limit deprivation. So what do we do with all this form? With bodies and form, God has a remedy, the continuity problem. To the continuity problem, we get to keep all of it. As long as we need it, we get to keep all of it. But it's all smoothed out, and you don't feel any suffering or deprivation or fear anywhere. It's all smoothed out. That's what the great mystics and realizers have told us. And I absolutely believe, I've examined this very carefully, and I do believe that they have shown us accurately what takes place. So all we have to do is take the medicine. I don't have a pain problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a body problem. I have a continuity problem. You can say that too. And just keep working on it, and you will find yourself coming out of this den of vipers. It is a generation of vipers right now in the world. There's no question about it. As bad can get, it seems like. And it's just a rotten, rotten world right now. So you can say, I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a pit of vipers problem. I have a continuity problem. And yet, if I don't recognize I have a continuity problem, I most certainly will suffer from the den of vipers, no question about it. So it's either one or the other. Each one denies the other. Can't have both. Can't have a solution to the continuity problem Unless we transfer over and say, no, I don't have a Den of Vipers problem. I have a continuity problem. If we don't do that, again, we will be stuck. Nothing that God can do. And then we'll be pulling each other's hair out, and you know, lawsuits flying everywhere. Just a whole jungle. It's a jungle here, just a nasty jungle in the world. Getting worse every second. So, I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a fatigue problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a fear problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an insecurity problem. I have a continuity problem. And the practice can be random. You don't have to specifically, is there something I have to say? No. Just whatever occurs to you. And just try and stick with it. It's not easy. I'm not having an easy time of it. And the results, it's not like trumpets suddenly appear. Trumpet your success or something. They might, but that's not how I experienced it. But the clarity, the overall clarity does increase. It's kind of like burning off fog, cloudy, foggy day. You know, what you pay attention to what you're doing, and you look up, and the sky is clearing a little bit, and you work some more, and then you look up, and it's better. And then one day you look up, and oh, it's just the clear sky. What happened to the clouds? So it kind of melts away, kind of evaporates away. It's more of an evaporation process. There's not dramatic gradations, really. That's what I've experienced. Get little glimpses of progress, just little glimpses, but nothing super dramatic that, like, you know, unnerves you, or anything like that. So don't look for success. Don't worry about looking for success. It will come of its own accord. What's important is to simply state the truth. Like, I don't have a body problem. I have a continuity problem. Just think about that. You're lifting all the concerns about the body off of the body. All your concerns and set over to the continuity problem, where God actually does have the remedy, the vision of oneness, the smoothed out, super smoothed out, perfect vision of oneness. There is a remedy there, but we have to have our attention there. Instead of claiming, no, I have a body problem. No, we don't. We have a continuity problem. Because all this identification with bodies is just our own desire, our own fear. God didn't do that. God's not identifying with bodies for us. This is nothing like that. It's all like a dream. It's all an imaginary dream, actually. So, like, use a dream as an analogy. It would be like, in a dream, we would say, I don't have a problem with this person chasing me in a dream. I have a waking problem. See, I'm afraid to wake up from the dream. You can say, I don't have a dream problem. I have a waking problem. So you identify everything in the dream. Say, that's like, wow, all this stuff's happening in the dream. You say, I don't have a, you know, problem with that. I have a waking problem. That's how you wake up from the dream, is saying, all this stuff that happens in the dream, no, that is not my problem. I don't have a problem with that at all. I have a waking problem. Very similar. So anything happens in this world is happening. Again, realize this world is nothing but an attempt to limit suffering, imaginary suffering. Very clever. We've been working on this for so long. And we think we found this little harbor finally. And we're like cowering in this little island, thinking that there's this vast storm, you know, and we just got our little huts on this little island, and we're just praying that we don't get hit by the big storm. And of course, the people in this world believe that very strongly, that what they're doing identifying with bodies is salvation, is protecting them from something much, much worse. And so they think that those who are dropping this ridiculous dream are crazy. And They just think it's just totally threatening. They think, oh my gosh, God's gonna find us. We're hiding from God, but God's gonna find us and deprive us of everything. Absolute nonsense. Just some kind of a fitful dream. I don't have a dream problem, I have a waking problem. That's the way to put it. I don't have a dream problem. I don't have dream problems, I have a waking problem. And as long as I have a waking problem, all these dream problems are going to continue to arise, for sure. But when we wake up from a dream, what happens to all the dream problems? They evaporate, don't they? After a little while moving around. They may stick with us, a nightmare may stick with us for a while, but gradually it evaporates, right? It's the same thing, waking up from this dream of limiting suffering is gradually, it evaporates. They use the analogy of like a ceiling fan, switching it off, and gradually it just slows down of its own accord. I don't have a dream problem, I have a waking problem. I don't have a people problem, I have a continuity problem. So, being the good, successful student is all important. It's all important. I have to keep working on it every day, even though nobody else is. Obviously, this world is incredibly derelict. As they continually try to avoid any thought of turning it around, the focus on this world is to identify with the body and form exclusively to such an extreme extent that we never even consider not doing it, because they think that not doing it is going to open us up then to the absolute wrath of God, the massive deprivation, spiritual deprivation of everything, of all reality. Everything's going to be annihilated. And so they think that this is safety, 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 and preach this. They preach their gospel continuously in every possible avenue in this world. It seems overwhelming, right? But you can say, I don't have a problem. I don't have a problem with that. I have a continuity problem. No matter what it is, I don't have a problem with people giving false preaching. I have a continuity problem. You see how powerful that medicine is? It transmutes. It's the ultimate alchemy. It really is. This statement, I don't have a problem with a pain problem. I have a continuity problem. That is the true alchemist stone that transmutes all of these problems into the one problem that God has the true remedy for, which is to give us this totally smoothed out, beautiful, still, calm overlay, a vision of oneness, of everything, equally everywhere, equal vision. This is the remedy for the continuity issue. And that is just waiting there for us. But we first have to recognize where the problem really is that we have. And not all this other stuff. And it does seem like alchemy, right? Because you say, well, I feel tired. But again, we only feel that tiredness as a defense against what we think is going to be infinite tiredness, which isn't there. So we have to be able to say, well, I don't have a fatigue problem. I have a continuity problem. In other words, you're agreeing in your mind, that's where I'm going to see the problem now. I'm going to shift from seeing the problem as fatigue, I'm going to now shift it over to seeing it as a continuity issue. Because we see fatigue, pain, suffering, aging, death, all that stuff. We're seeing it because we want to see it. We want it as a problem to minimize some greater problem. So we're literally seeing this purposefully. It's a purposeful thing we're doing. So I see fatigue. I'm experiencing fatigue because I think it's saving me from something much worse. So we need to say, change and say, I don't need to see fatigue as a problem anymore. I don't have a fatigue problem. And then when I see that, God will then give the remedy and I'll say, I accept that remedy. Because we really do have a continuity problem. It's legit. It's legitimate. I don't have a fatigue problem. I have a continuity problem. This is true spiritual alchemy. And anyone can do it. It's the simplest thing at all. You just whatever your situation is, say, I don't have a boredom problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a estrangement problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a depression problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a sadness problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an uncertainty problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a worry problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an insecurity problem. I have a continuity problem. Just keep on doing this. I don't have a time problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a medicine problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a financial problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a concern problem. I have a continuity problem. So deny the worldly concerns and transfer them over to the continuity problem. Absolutely, we can do that. Because again, all these concerns and problems we have, they're imaginary. We've invented them. We've invented them, but they're still imaginary. It's like we're dreaming them. And we think we're doing it to protect us from what we think is some incredible deprivation, but we're also dreaming that. The massive deprivation we think is going to hit us if we don't limit it. We're also dreaming that. That's also just imaginary. So, again, we're so used to this dream of limiting the problems that we're afraid to give it up. That's a continuity problem. We're afraid to stop identifying with bodies. Absolutely. You listen to the top sages, saviors, gurus, etc., and they will tell you that they're not identified with their body in the slightest bit. Not in the slightest bit. To them, it's just like a rag doll, an inert rag doll. There's no identification with it in the way we identify with it. They don't see it as their self at all. Again, if we had like a little rag doll, you know, we'd look at that and say, oh, it's a little rag doll. That's how they see their body. They don't see it as what they are at all. Not at all. Because they don't have the continuity problem has been solved for them. They've accepted it. And they know that God's not depriving them of anything. So there's no reason then, there's no fear, no reason to limit the fear of deprivation at all. No reason to identify with the body whatsoever or with form whatsoever. None. None. That's why they're calm, peaceful, serene, in a different state of mind, unconcerned, totally unconcerned by all this suffering and misery that's happening in the world. Which is, again, all done on purpose. We're the ones doing it. These pep talks are necessary, both for me and for the world, for those students of the world. I'm trying to be a student to encourage others to keep on keeping on, because the times are ruinous. They're so ruinous, it's like a typhoon. We're being hit like with a typhoon of misdirection in the world, away from the truth that we know to be true, which is, I don't have a world problem, I have a continuity problem. It's all going, focusing on saying we have a world problem. All the money, all the cleverness of the world is focused on that. And by the way, The world is not intelligent at all. It's clever. This technique of trying to limit deprivation by identifying with the world body's form is very clever, but it's not intelligent in the slightest bit. Intelligence would show you that it's totally bogus and unnecessary, but that we do have a continuity problem. That's intelligence. And so there's very little intelligence on this planet. Almost none. A little tiny bit. So all this cleverness now is pushing to an enormous extent, pressurizing and pushing us to adopt a worldview instead of a world problem instead of a continuity problem. So it's very much a crisis, because if you don't see that our only problem is the continuity problem and accept that, for sure you're going to then buy into that we have all these millions and, you know, world problem. Everybody's a problem. Everything's a problem. We have this massive problem here, you know, in the world. You're going to buy into that and then go set about frantically trying to solve all those problems, and you're going to get sucked into another cycle of existence, of this dream. Complete waste of time. You could say, I don't have a cycle of existence problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a reincarnation problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a rebirth problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a universal problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a galactic problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an ET problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, it may seem feeble when you try it, but the same thing like when you try to start exercising and you're out of shape, it seems feeble. But within a couple weeks, what are you doing? You're running, right? So, of course it's going to seem feeble. It seems feeble to me at this point, too, a little bit. But you'll suddenly start to feel more adamant about it. And you'll start to catch your wind, you catch a second wind. You say, hey, it's doable. You say, I don't have an effort problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an intelligence problem, I have a continuity problem. That's another way. I don't have a cold problem, I've got a continuity problem. I don't have a weather problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a climate problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a resource problem, I have a continuity problem. And don't try to figure out how it works exactly, because it's totally simple. You're simply transferring all your concerns over to this one issue, the continuity issue, which is where it all legitimately belongs. Again, all the problems, you might be dreaming this nightmare that's got like millions and millions of problems, it's so problematical, and then you wake up from the dream, what happens to all the problems? And they never were real in the first place. That's exactly like our situation. So transfer all your concern for everything that's happening in the dream over to the just the one concern of waking up from the dream. And then that is where you're on the same page with God, and God says, yeah, that's the only problem you have, and I have the remedy for you, so don't worry. It's going to be totally smooth, totally gentle, easy awakening from the dream, slow, gradual awakening. So, in California, we can say, I don't have a drought problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a water problem. I have a continuity problem. Because again, every problem of this world has all been designed with the imagination of mind to try and limit deprivation, limit suffering to a little bit of suffering, a little bit of deprivation, try to shrink it down. We can't get rid of it, but we think we can limit it. See, we're dealing from a standpoint of weakness and being overwhelmed, and we think we're able to limit it through our cleverness, limit it. And of course the deprivation is constantly taking place, but you know, we feel, well, it's limited. Well, okay, so I'm body suffering. Okay, it's not so bad. At least my spirit is not, you know, annihilated. So, of course, continually you will have problems in the world. That's what it's all about, is to shrink deprivation and suffering down to a manageable level, we think. That's it. And if we stop identifying with bodies, we get frightened and say, oh my gosh, where's the body? I got to identify because I got to make sure I'm identifying with something that's can only suffer a little while. You know, bodies, what do they suffer for 85 years or something, and then they die? And so we think, wow, we're cheating spiritual death because we're only suffering and for a little while. a little bit of suffering. It's over. Once the body dies, all the suffering's over, we say. We're saved. Our suffering's finished. Of course, this is just a delusion. Because the continuity issue, we haven't accepted the resolution of it. So we reincarnate, we identify with it, we keep trying to shrink the suffering down, the fear of deprivation down. Don't have a reincarnation problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an existential problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a spiritual problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have any problem except the continuity problem. And with that, we'll end the video. Just take the medicine. Practice this. Practice, 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 practice. And when you start to not practice, you take a look at the news and you say, oh boy, I better get back to practicing, right? Okay, very great. That's it.